Friends, welcome to the Agrigo channel, and here is the next chapter. This is regarding the plant breeding procedure. And we know this pure line selection and mass selection, whatever the PowerPoint is there, this is made by one of my best friend who is now junior scientist in Keonjhar RRTS, and he is from Department of Genetics and Plant Breeding, and his name is Prasanth Varmaji. Though actually my friend is not available here, it is why whatever the PowerPoint presentation, it is made by the Prasanth Varmaji, and I am just supporting his PowerPoint. So first of all, I will thank Mr. Prasanth. Thank you so much for being a member of this our family, the Agrigo, and we are really proud of you that you are with us. Okay, thank you. So let us go. As we know that this selection, pure line selection and mass selection. Okay, so if actually I will teach this pure line selection, mass selection, as Mr. Prasanth is not available here, so I will try to teach in a better way. Though I am not a plant breeder, I am from agronomy department. I am an agronomist. And if time permits, then Mr. Prasanth will come and teach you, okay? And we hope he will come soon. Okay, so let us think. This is the pure line selection, mass selection, which is the main long question which comes from the OPSC mains exam. What is the civil service mains exam? This is one of the most important questions. And as well as this question is also asked in various entrance examinations, whether it may be IBPS Lubbock exam, that means AFO exam, or it may be ICAR entrance examination regarding the general agriculture portion, as well as for the breeding portions also. So let us, I will try my best to teach you. Okay, so let us think. Okay, here is the person. Mr. Prasanth is there. Mr. Prasanth, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Prasanth. Very nice PowerPoint he has made. Okay, so let us go to the next slide. Now, first of all, in case of pure line selection, now the question which is asked in the civil service exam, and it is the mains paper, and it is the mains paper. This is the paper 1 of mains. You can say this is OPSC. Mains paper 1, it is asked, what is the question? The question is, describe the briefly the procedure, as well as procedure and application and advantage and disadvantage of the pure line selection from the plant breeding. Okay, so a very nice presentation I have already told you. So how do we approach this question? First thing is that we have to describe the introduction, then applications of pure line selection, then we should go for procedure, very different. These are the things. In this way, we will answer in our exam paper. Okay, so first of all, I want to share something. First of all, I want to share something that so now, first of all, we have to understand what do you mean by selection. Okay. Selection means this is nothing but we have to just select one population. We have to identify one population from the number of plants. There are so many number of plants are there, and we have to select or we have to identify one plant. Okay. So basically, this selection is of two way. First thing is that it may be natural selection or it may be artificial selection. Okay, so now you think, in normal environment, natural selection is, now as we know, there are number of plants. So many plants are there in our locality. And we know that in nature, what happens? In nature, climate change happens. There are some natural calamities are there. And we know that out of all these plants, some of the plants will survive. We know some of the plants will survive in the upcoming time. Because as natural calamities are there, so climate change is happening, so most of the plants are affected, or most of the plants are susceptible to the adverse climatic condition. But there are some plants who will adapt. There are plants who can adapt the new environment or the changing environment. This is due to the natural selection. As we know, in the evolution process, we know the survival of the fittest. What is this? This is the natural selection. So, let us see that the plants who will selected by nature. So, whatever the plants who are selected by the nature, they are based on their adaptability. Okay? So, जो जितना भी plant है, अगर उसमें से अभी natural calamity change हो रहा है, तो उसके हिसाब से कुछ कुछ plant क्या हो जाएगा? डिस्ट्रॉय हो जाएगा वो, और कुछ कुछ प्लांट होगा जो कि वो दे विल अडैप्ट टू द चेंजिंग एनवायरनमेंट. सो जो भी नेचुरल सिलेक्शन होगा दे विल डायरेक्टली इंडिकेट द अडैप्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द प्लांट, और वी कैन से द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द प्लांट. वी कैन से इट इज नथिंग बट द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द प्लांट. ओके, एंड व्हाट एवर द प्लांट्स हु आर सिलेक्टेड बाय द नेचर, जो भी नेचर के द्वारा वो सिलेक्ट होगा, ये तो नहीं होगा जो प्लांट सिलेक्ट होगा वो हमारे लिए जरूरी, ये तो नहीं होगा ना. सो इसलिए व्हाट हैपेंस, व्हाटएवर प्लांट्स व्हिच आर नेचुरली सिलेक्टेड, दे मे बी इंपोर्टेंस, दे मे हैव इंपोर्टेंस फॉर आवर सेल्फ, यस और नो, और दे may not have. So whatever the plants who are naturally selected, either they have importance for ourselves, वो हमारे लिए important है, वो हमारे लिए important नहीं भी हो सकते हैं, ये तो नहीं है ना, ये तो nature select कर रहा है, हम तो select नहीं कर रहे हैं, तो जब nature select कर रहा है, वो शायद हमारे लिए important हो सकता है, और हमारे लिए important नहीं भी हो सकता है. But if we come to this session, this is artificial selection. Now artificial means now we will select these plants. We select the plants. Out of these best populations, which plant I want to select? This plant I want to select. So this is based on our desirability. Okay, जो भी artificial selection हो रहा है, this is based on desirability. This is based on our desirability. Okay? So this is the things. So what is our desirability? Our desirability may be the yield, or it may be the disease resistance. It may be the disease resistance, or it may be for hybridization, whatever else. So basically there are two types of selection. Jo nature karta hai, aur jo hum kar rahe hain usko bolte hain artificial selection. जो हम करेंगे वो हमारे डिजायरेबल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स है. हम क्या चाहते हैं, हम डिजीज रेजिस्टेंस चाहते हैं या हम ज्यादा यील्ड चाहते हैं. लेकिन जैसे हम देखें इधर नेचुरल सिलेक्शन में कुछ भी हो सकता है, वो हमारे लिए इंपॉर्टेंट हो सकता है, हमारे लिए इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं भी हो सकता है, ये तो नेचर कर रहा है, ये हमारे हाथ में नहीं है, हमारे हाथ में ये वाला है आर्टिफिशियल सिलेक्शन. सो बेसिकली दिस इज द थिंग्स. आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज द सिलेक्शन. सो नाउ Let us move to another point. So my point is, what is the effectivity of the selection? If I will ask, what is the effectivity of the selection? What is the effectivity means? As we will go for the artificial selection, whether my artificial selection is effective or not, who will decide? Now, who will decide? It will be decided by the base population. Another thing, it will decide by the character what I have chosen. First you should remember, what do you mean by base population? So here just base population means, what is base population? So base population means the initial population from which we want to select the plants. This is the initial population. And we know in initial population, there are a number of varieties of the plants are there. Number of genotypes are there, genotypes of the plants are there. So out of those base population, we want to select. Okay? So now, the effective selection is based upon the base population. Now here, the base population should have high genetic variation. The base population should have high genetic variation. Now you think, in case of selection, we are identifying the plant. Whatever we are identifying the plant, this is based on the phenotype. Yes or no? And we know that the phenotype is nothing but that. It is the phenotype is equal to genotype plus environment plus genotype into environment. Interaction of the genotype and environment. Okay? So whatever the phenotypes are there, this is directly or it is affected by the genotype. Yes or no? So abhi socho. Abhi agar main bolunga ki my name is Jitendra Kumar Nair. So I will say I am a good student. Abhi main bol raha hu ki main ek acha student hu. Acha student means main acha padhta hu. Okay? एंड मैं क्लास में फर्स्ट आ रहा हूँ. अभी बोलो आप, क्या मैं सही बोल रहा हूँ? मैं अच्छा स्टूडेंट हूँ? अभी सोचो, मेरे क्लास में 40 बच्चे हैं. कितने बच्चे हैं? 40 बच्चे हैं. अभी मैं बोल रहा हूँ कि मैं अच्छा, आई एम ए वेरी टैलेंटेड स्टूडेंट. आई एम सेइंग दैट आई एम वेरी टैलेंटेड स्टूडेंट. व्हाई? बिकॉज आई स्टार्ट फर्स्ट इन माई क्लास, एंड इन माई क्लास देर आर 40 स्टूडेंट्स. In all over Odisha, I will say, in all over the Odisha, I am the first student. I am the very much talented student. It is right? Is it right? No. It is not right. I am first in my class, not in my district, not in my state, not in my country. Likewise. Why? Because abhi hum 40 ke bachche ke sath mujhe compare kar raha hu. जो हमार आई एम कंपेयरिंग माई सेल्फ विथ अदर 40 स्टूडेंट्स. बट नाउ यू सी, इफ आई विल कंपेयर माई सेल्फ विथ द अदर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ माई डिस्ट्रिक्ट, देन आई माइट नॉट बी द टैलेंटेड स्टूडेंट. यस, लाइक वाइज. सो वेदर आई एम टैलेंटेड स्टूडेंट और नॉट, आई विल डिसाइड इफ आई विल कंपेयर विथ द नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स. Likewise, whatever the selections are there, if the high variation will be there in the base population, then whatever the superior phenotype which I want to select, this is the selection is more effective. अगर ज़्यादा variation होगा base population में, तो उसमें से हम एक plant निकालेंगे जो सबसे superior होगा, तो उसका selection जो superiority होगा, वो selection वो more effective होगा. अगर हम चार plant में से एक plant को best बोलेंगे, तो इतना इफेक्टिव नहीं होगा. अगर हम 10 प्लांट्स में 10 प्लांट है उसमें हम बोलेंगे एक ये अच्छा प्लांट है, तो ये सिलेक्शन मोर इफेक्टिव होगा. ये सुन लो. यस, अभी सोचो मेरे पास 5 प्लांट है. 5 प्लांट में से मैं बोलूंगा दिस प्लांट इज मोर इफेक्टिव, दिस इज मोर सुपीरियर. अभी जो सिलेक्शन हुआ ये 5 प्लांट से हमने एक को सिलेक्ट किया, सो ये इतना इफेक्टिव नहीं है. अभी सोचो आई विल टेक 10 प्लांट्स, सो आउट ऑफ 10 प्लांट्स आई विल से दिस प्लांट इज मोर इफेक्टिव. नाउ दिस नाउ एज कम्पेयर टू प्रीवियस वन, नाउ दिस एग्जाम्पल इज मोर इफेक्टिव. आउट ऑफ 10 नाउ इट इज बेस्ट, बट हियर आउट ऑफ 5 इट इज बेस्ट. सो एज वी आर इंक्रीजिंग द प्लांट पॉपुलेशन, द इफेक्टिविटी ऑफ द सिलेक्शन विल इंक्रीज. So, for most effective selection, the best population should be high genetic variation should be there. Second one, the character. Whatever the characters I have taken, these characters should have more heritable in nature. जो भी हम कैरेक्टर ले रहे हैं दिस कैरेक्टर शुड बी मोर हेरिटेबल इन नेचर. दैट मीन्स यू सी अभी मैं बोलूंगा कि एक कैरेक्टर लेते हैं लेट आई विल टेक वन कैरेक्टर दिस इज एवी. अभी सोचो जो हेरिटेबल होगा जो भी हेरिटेबल होगा कौन सा है वाला कैरेक्टर हेरिटेबल होगा. आई नो व्हाट वाला कैरेक्टर सर दे आर अफेक्टेड बाय द जीनोटाइप एंड द एनवायरमेंट. व्हाट एवर द कैरेक्टर्स आर देयर दे आर अफेक्टेड बाय जीनोटाइप एंड एनवायरमेंट. बट यू नो इफ द कैरेक्टर इज मोर इन्फ्लुएंस्ड और इज मोर कंट्रोल्ड बाय द जीनोटाइप. इफ द आई एम सेइंग दैट इफ द कैरेक्टर इज मोर कंट्रोल्ड बाय द जीनोटाइप एज कंपेयर टू एनवायरमेंट देन दिस कैरेक्टर विल बी मोर हेरिटेबल इन नेचर. यस और नो? यस. सो आई एम सेइंग दैट if the character is controlled by genotype maximum then the character will be called as more heritable. If the reverse is if the character is less controlled by the genotype and more controlled by the environment then this is less heritable in nature. So whatever the characters we have taken the character should have more heritable in nature. The character should have more heritable in nature. So this is the concept. What is selection, you know? And how you want to increase the effectivity of the selection. Effectivity of the selection. Okay. Another thing you want to know before going to this pure line selection or mass selection. Another term you should know that you know here two terms are there. One is homozygous. One term is homozygous. Another term is heterozygous. Remember what is I am saying? Homozygous, heterozygous. Homozygous means same allele should be there. Same allele. These are the alleles. If I will say gene, A gene, like this is A gene, it has two alleles. One is capital A, another is small A. So, if the genotype is the only capital A, or it may be small a, then we can say it is homozygous in nature. Okay? That means in a cell, whatever the alleles are there, they are similar. Here capital A, small a. These are called as the homozygous. Now, if I will tell heterozygous. Heterozygous means one is capital A, another is small a. Okay, one is dominant, another is recessive. In case of homozygous, either both are dominant or both are recessive. In case of heterozygous, either one is dominant and another one is recessive. This is all. So this is homozygous and another is heterozygous. So now you see here another term you just remember. One is homogeneous. One is homogeneous, another is heterogeneous. What do you mean by homogeneous? Homogeneous means the plant should contain only one gene. What is homogeneous means the plant should contain one gene. Now you say, now the gene is A. So the plant may contain either AA or it may contain AA. Or it may contain AA. So if a population has this type only one gene, here gene is A. A gene is there. Here it is called as the homogeneous. But what do you mean by heterogeneous? AA, BB, AA, BB, CC, DD. So there are different genes are there. So here I have taken A gene, B gene, C gene and D gene. So if more than one genes are there, so we call this heterogeneous. If only one gene is there, it is called as homogeneous. Okay, very good. So next thing, next term you should remember. Now you say, I am writing this, if I will write homozygous, and heterogeneous, homozygous and heterogeneous. What do you mean by homozygous? What should be the population? Here it will be the base population. I am saying the here I will say that this is boss population, and whatever the base population is there, the plants are homozygous and heterogeneous. Homozygous means only dominant should be there, or maybe recessive should be there. Heterogeneous. Heterogeneous means A gene, B gene, C gene is there. This is homozygous, heterogeneous. So if I will say homozygous and homogeneous, if I will say homozygous and homogeneous, then the base population will be homozygous and homogeneous, means only one gene will be there. So homozygous AA can be there. Again, AA will be there. AA will be there. AA will be there. BB nahi hoga, kyunki it is homogeneous in nature. So only one gene, only A gene should be there. And homozygous means only dominant. Either it may both are dominant or both are recessive. Okay. Now another term. If I will write here, I am writing homozygous heterogeneous. So here I will write heterozygous homogeneous. You say heterozygous and homogeneous. What do you mean the population? Population will be heterozygous but homogeneous. Homogeneous means only one gene. So the plant will be like this. Capital S, small n. Okay. Now, if I will write heterozygous and heterogeneous, now the plant population will be heterozygous and heterogeneous. Means heterozygous AA, heterogeneous BB, CC, BD, AA. So these are the populations we have found in heterozygous and heterogeneous. Means heterozygous condition should be there. Dominant one dominant and one recessive allele, and number of genes are there. So these are the basic concepts you have to remember. Okay. So now another thing, I hope you have all understood that basic thing. So now you just see here. In case of pure line selection, you just remember what do you mean by pure line? Pure line means it is nothing but it is a progeny of a parent. It is a progeny of a parent, but the parent should be homozygous in nature. The parent should be homozygous in nature, or we can say the parent is mainly self-pollinated crop. The parents are mainly self-pollinated crop, or we can say the homozygous in nature. Okay, so I will say here, you can say here, like this is AA and this will be AA. Now whatever the progenies are there,